songs for Chase. Chase.
Yeah.
Vinny.
We'll be right back.
Welcome to Tuesday Behind the Kit. And I'm Vinny Appice. Not a piece. Let me make that louder. All right. There we go. It's got a little reverb on there. Hey, thanks for joining me, and Behind the Kit, episode number, who's counting? I wish I did count, because it's been going on for a while, you know? And when we first started this show, I used to try to figure out, let's show some foot exercises, you know, and... And let's show this, and let's show, but it's like now I just wing it because I can't think of anything else. Whatever comes my way. And all this stuff I just played, I call it lead bass drum. You know, it leads with the bass drum. It makes it heavier and powerful. And it's, you know, bass drum, it's got all the power in the kit, more than the snare and more than anything. Especially when the bass drum sounds big. If it's deadened a lot, it doesn't sound so big, but it's still the big guy in the kit, you know. So I like to play a lot of bass drum in these beats. You can start off simple. Simple beat, right? See, that's a good way to practice. I like practicing like that. You know, just set up a groove. 8 bars, 16 bars, whatever you want to do. Now go for it. Back to the simple groove. Again. Back to the groove. But you gotta repeat yourself so it's musical. It's like this. This pattern, something like this. Boom, boom, ba-da, boom, boom, ba-da, boom, boom, ba-da. You know, you repeat it and it's almost like a bass riff or a guitar riff. You know? If you don't play anything that repeats, it gets a little messy. I mean, it's cool if you can stay with it, but it's easier to repeat. People in the audience and listeners get it more, you know? Groove, I can go forever, but we're only here for 50 minutes, so. Anyway, I hope all you guys are doing good. This is presented by Sawtooth Drums, and that's what I'm using, as you can see from there and in the front. And this is the Hickory Kit, 6 plies of pure hickory, no added preservatives. And this is part of a little bit bigger kit, which is two more toms. I have a 10, a 12, 13, 14, 16, 18, and a 6.5-inch snare drum. All sawtooth, all hickory. And these drums have die-cast hoops and solid steel lugs. Now, the die-cast hoops are interesting, especially on the snare. That means it's rounded toward the inside like this. Can you see that? A lot of rims are the other way. They go toward the outside. And I noticed I played some of those at the rock camp I just did, and it chews up the sticks a lot more. This gives, this is stronger when it's a die cast hoop, and it gives you a bigger sound. Gives you a big sound with this and with the die-cast hoops, and it's a lot more powerful, I find. So I never noticed that before until recently. It takes me a while sometimes, you know. Now, the other things that are cool are I play these beats with a lot of grace notes. You know, grace notes are the little notes, the ghost notes in between. See, so without grace notes, it's kind of straight, right? You put the grace notes in. Grace notes are on the snare drum. That one in particular is this. And the accents are on the 2 and 4. Straight. So those are the grace notes. Very important, very important, very important to get in the groove. And fast. The last one was more of a paradiddle. Of course, you got to play steady. That's my whole thing. I should get a shirt that says, play steady, you know? I just did a rock camp, but was it 2 weekends ago? And I had to implement the play steady rule, you know? Especially with fills. Some guys get nervous when there's a fill or there's a something, there's a groove. Like that, you know, and it starts to rush that part, you know. Like, you start to think of that as mechanical, like, not as feeling it, you know. I did it on here so you could hear it. In the pocket. Best thing, which helps, listen to metronomes. Everything's nice and steady, nice and steady, nice and steady. So. What is that? You know, I did that in a song by Dio, Stand Up and Shout. I quite figured out exactly what that is. think it's just the accents of 16th notes. So it makes it weird. Supposed to end somewhere sooner, but I play it different. So, so that's what's going on here. And I mic'd the drums different this time. I don't know what they sound like. I'll have to listen back. You know, I had different mics and tried to use my Focusrite interfaces to go right into Facebook, but it doesn't work that way. Once this is installed in your computer, only input 1 and 2 will go to Facebook. So even if you have all these other mics on the toms, and they go left and right, and it's just a big mess. Only 1 and 2 go into Facebook. It's really weird. So you need to use a mixer. So the mixer, I just use one mixer. I got two overheads here. And we got mics on. When I got the mics on the drums, no, two overheads, which are getting the toms, and snare drum, kick drum, and what else I got? Vocal mic and a la-la mic. And that's it. So the overheads are getting the toms, you know, and some of the kick, and there's a bass drum mic in the kick. Then I also noticed that some of the other mics that are plugged in, like, might be on. Maybe not this one. That's the hi-hat. No, not that one. And then we got the la-la mic. Hi, la-la.
Hello.
You can move that over a little bit.
Trying to keep it good.
There. Now we could hear you.
Woo-hoo.
I'll make you louder. When I make la-la louder and me louder, it's called room mics. Hear a different sound. So anyway, how are you, Lala?
I'm doing good.
You got your hair done today.
Yes, I did.
It looks nice.
Thank you.
I'd say come show the people, but you'd have to walk all the way over here.
I'd be a little hard to get behind.
I might bite you.
Caught up in all the...
So anyway, here we got some. I got some dates coming up, and
yep.
I'll have Lollipop read them to you. Starting with, what is it,
418? Another rock and roll.
Get up on that mic, honey.
We got another rock and roll fantasy camp.
Yeah.
April 18th. With Chad Smith from Red Hot Chili Peppers. Noodles from,
Noodles is from,
I know, but wait, hang on.
Right in. Who's Noodles from? Noodles is from Offspring?
Offspring, that's right. I couldn't remember.
And we got the M3 Festival. When is that?
That is May 4th.
Right, and that's Columbia, Maryland, even though the bridge in Maryland just got hit by a big cargo ship.
Yeah.
Holy ship.
Not good.
That's all I got to say.
And
I don't know if you've seen that on the news.
Yeah,
that thing was loaded with cargo shipping containers. It almost looked like it was too many containers on there, but lost power and hit the bridge, took the bridge out. Boom. Yeah. So the bridge is gone and the port's gone in Maryland. So we're playing there in 5-4. I don't know if that impacts us. I don't know if we have to take the bridge.
I have no idea.
Take me to the bridge. Take us to the bridge. Yeah, that's a cool beat too. When you keep the bass drum on all the fours, or six or eighth notes. That's a good thing to practice, where you can do that for 8 bars or 16 bars, 4 bars, whatever you want to do, and then play something in between and come back like this. We'll be right back. off the top of my head. Okay, so that was the M3 Festival on May 4th. Then what do we got?
And then May 5th, Cinco de Mayo.
Cinco de Mayo.
That's Jurgles. That's with Last in Line, both of those.
These are with Last in Line, that's right.
Yep.
Where's Jurgles?
In Warmdale, Pennsylvania. Nice little venue.
Yeah, that's a cool place.
Times.
And then it turns to Sabbath nights.
Yeah, because Viv's out with Def Leppard.
Vivian's out with Def Leppard.
All summer, so we will be out with
So we don't see Viv. So I'm doing some shows with Sabbath nights, which is I got a killer band, kick-ass band, with Jim Crean on vocals. And we're playing the Akata Theater in St. Charles, Illinois.
May 18th.
And what's the next one?
May 19th, the Golden Record in St. Louis, Missouri.
Yeah, which is 300 miles away, so we got to figure out what mode of transport we're doing. Should we take the private jet, Lala?
Yes.
Okay. And so that's what Sabbath Nights. And Sabbath Nights is a lot of the stuff I played on from Mob Rules, from Dehumanizer, and some stuff from Heaven and Hell, which I didn't play on that album, but I played the song so many times live. And a little bit of Old Sabbath. So it's a great Sabbath night and some Dio sprinkled in a couple songs by Dio. And it's a lot of fun for me. I love playing that stuff. And come down to the shows if you see us playing somewhere. You'll have fun and you'll know all the songs. Not like some bands that go, we're going to do an original from our new album. And some people go, yeah. And then the rest of the people going, they got a new album? That album's the Last in Line, actually.
That does.
Yeah, okay. So. And then on the 19th, I'll tell it, there's a Rock for Ronnie to raise money for the Cancer Fund. And that's May 19th, and that's at Warner Center Park in Woodland Hills, California. Funny thing with that is, I used to live right there on that street where the park is. There's a park, and then there's a bunch of townhouses. I had a townhouse there. And so that's the 19th. I think Quiet Riot's playing with Rudy. Rudy was very close to Ronnie, and so that should be good. And, of course, I missed it.
Yeah, we're going to miss it.
We're going to be in St. Louis.
Yeah.
Every time they book Ronnie Ride for Cancer or whatever it is they call it, I can't go. So. And then what's next?
We got May 31st at the Viper Room.
In Hollywood.
Hollywood, yeah. And that's with Michelangelo Badio, right?
That's with Michael Badio, and on drums is Joe Fuoco, who owns and runs Sawtooth Drums and all the rest of the companies affiliated. Chromacast is the company that makes the hardware and the foot pedal. A lot of people ask, what kind of foot pedal is that? Well, this is a Chromacast foot pedal. And it's, I think, the only one they make. They don't make different levels. I think this is the one. The one is all you need, you know. And a very fast pedal when you tighten it up and adjust it to your liking. That's what you got to do with pedals. To get all those triplets out or 16ths. Those are the 16ths. I love those things. So that's the Chromacast pedal. So Joe is the drummer with Michael Badio, and we're playing together. We got a sawtooth kit there, so I'm going to use a small kit. And it should be a great show. It's a small place. It's going to be, it's going to be packed.
Yep.
So bring an umbrella.
It will be very packed.
And then after that, what's that?
The next day. June 1st at Stages in Santa Ana.
Speaking of that mic, honey.
I am. I'm right next to it.
Oh. Okay.
June
Where is
1st.
That? Where is that? What's it called?
Stages in Santa Ana.
Why is it called Stages?
It's always been called Stages. No, it's been called, it used to be called Malone's. No,
Malone's. It used to be called Malone's, right? Yeah. Stages, because there's two stages.
There is.
Yeah. The only thing I don't like is we got to kill the drums once we set up for sound check. Oy, oy, oy. And then there's one last thing on the list for now.
July 18th, Rock and Roll Fantasy Camp in New York City.
New York City.
With Rick Nielsen.
Rick Nielsen.
Cheap Trick. And Lou Gramm for Foreigner. That's big.
Yeah, and Lou's going to retire, I think, the end of this year.
Yeah, that's what he said.
Yeah, so if you want to catch Lou,
that's
you want to play with Lou, there's a Rock Fantasy Camp, July 18th.
Yep.
Yeah, that should be a good one. And that's it for now. There'll be more coming up. I'm doing a gig with Liliac. We become very good friends, Liliac and I. Because when they came out with the Rainbow in the Dark video, this is years ago, everybody called me and said, you got to see this band. She sounds like Ronnie doing Rainbow in the Dark. I went, yeah. You know, I get that a lot where somebody, you got to see this band. And then I go, check it out. And it's not so good, but that was great. And I went, wow. So I contacted them and told them what a great job they did on that song, you know. So I'm going to be doing three gigs with them in September.
Yeah.
On my birthday.
Yeah.
My birthday is September 13th. I don't know if it falls on Friday the 13th.
I think it might.
Because I was born on Friday the 13th, and that's why I wound up playing with all these evil bands.
No.
Nah, they're not evil. Maybe some of them are. But anyway, that's three gigs that I'm going to post. You've probably seen the ad. They post a lot of stuff. And we're going to do a triple tribute, a tribute to Rainbow, which I like, Dio, which I like, and Sabbath, a triple dipple, let's call it, and that's with Melody singing and the band, and I'll be playing drums, and I'm not using in-ears either, like they do.
Nope.
I'm using monitors, old school loud monitors.
That's why you can't hear.
What?
That's why you can't hear.
She's right.
She's right.
She is right. We went out the other night for her daughter's birthday at a place that had tons of background noise with everybody yakking in this room, and it was reflective. And I'm there going, oh, my God. I need some closed-captioned sunglasses.
You need a hearing aid for that situation.
What?
Huh?
So, anyway, that's what's cooking, baby. And let's take some questions. What song is this?
By Sharona.
Holy crap, you got it. What song is this? What's that?
I can't tell yet. You have to do it again.
Nah, it's nothing. What's this? That's Cinco de Mayo. You see, you could even practice with that silly beat and play in between, like. Got to be creative, especially when you're on this show. All right, question.
Well, there was a comment. In the beginning, the sound was a little hinky. I think Facebook was messing with it.
Oh, really?
And then it got better, so I'm not sure what was going on.
You know, I spend hours on the sound. It drives me up a wall.
Yeah, it was weird. It was kind of muffly, and then it seemed like
oh, really?
It was an issue. And then all of a sudden, it got better, so I don't know. What, maybe they didn't like you doing something.
Oh, shit. I didn't curse.
No, I don't know.
I didn't talk politics.
It was kind of weird, but now it got better.
I didn't do nothing.
It glitched.
That's
just Facebook. There's nothing you can do about it.
It could be Facebook. You know, the bandwidth is almost, it is what it is.
Yeah.
And I try to get the drums loud, you know, and I notice Now they probably sound okay. The bass drum sounds big. But when I played it a song, the song takes up, and that's an MP3, takes up a lot of the bandwidth, and the drums are fighting with the song. And what's a mother to do, you know? I sit here for hours. Yesterday I was here for probably 3 hours, messing with different mics and plugging them in, trying to get the best sound. All for you guys. So I want you to have good quality sound. And I want to sound good. Otherwise, what's the point here? You know? Okay, so question.
Oh, it's a comment. Jeffrey just bought a sawtooth kit for his son, and it's coming this week.
Oh, really?
Yay.
Cool. Did he specify which one? Because
no, he did not.
This is the Hickory series, and then there's the Command series, which is made from alderwood. And I used that for 5 years, and they're cheaper drums. They don't cost as much as this, but they sound great, you know? But these drums, this is like, you know, all the wing nuts and everything's a little bit oversized, really strong. It's got the die-cast hoops. And so they both sound great. So good luck, man. That's great. Thank you for doing that. They'll be happy to know that. Ah, I wonder what color you got.
I don't know.
Okay. See, this kit comes in two different colors. It comes in a brown. Then it comes in this... this kind of tan stuff here. Not tan, but this more like a maple, dark maple, see? So the other one's got a wrap, so they come in a number of colors. Okay, what else we got?
What else have we got? Okay, what are the sizes of the drums again?
My sizes of the drums right here are 13, 14. This is 13, 14, 16, 18. And they're deep. I don't know what the deepness is, but they're deeper. They're not small. You can see it on the video. They're pretty deep. Bass drum's 24 by 14. And great sound of bass drum. I don't like the extended bass drums myself. I'd rather go in the height for the tone, you know. And that's what it is. Snare is 14 by 6.5. That's it. And
ooh, okay, another question.
And that song, I played it for Jace. He was the first one on. He requested the Juggler by Axis, my band Axis, from 1977, 78. Three-piece band. Danny Johnson on guitar, Jay Davis on bass, and me on the drums, and we were produced by Andy Johns. It's a good record, and the drums sound really good. It's the actual album that Tony Iommi listened to when I joined Black Sabbath. When I first met him, he came walking in with the record. And he said it's really good. So he liked the drumming. He liked the sound. So he knew I was capable of powering the band because that's what drummers do. And so that was for Jace. He requested that.
Yeah.
And that goes way back to 78, you know. So it's really cool to see a young kid like Jace, you know, diving into some of this old music, you know. It's good. There's no click on it. There's nothing. Andy Johns produced it. Andy Johns did a lot of Zeppelin stuff, and he got a killer drum sound on it. So check it out. Okay, next question.
When playing with Iommi and Butler, what was their technique, and how did it work with your drumming technique?
How did it work? Well, their technique is they play the way they play. Tony plays behind the beat, big chords, and Geezer follows Tony a lot, and then he also plays against Tony, you know, gets a little bit busy on the bass. So I kind of try to fit in between that. You know, I'll listen to Geese and I'll pick up what his accents are and play that, but still maintain that heaviness of Tony's guitar. And Tony plays kind of behind the beat, you know. So that's why I learned really to lay back. So it's all about listening. It's all about listening, you know. When you get in a band, listen. Keep your ears open, and you listen to the bass, you listen to the guitar. I like to do a scan, you know. When I'm playing with Last in Line, I'll listen to Vivian, you know, and play along with him. Sometimes I try to knock him off. He laughs. And then I'll listen to Phil, play with Phil. Sometimes me and Andy, Andrew Freeman on the vocals, we do a couple things together. So you got to listen. That's the most important thing. Don't play like this. You know, like your eyes are closed, your head's down. You're in another world you're playing. I don't recommend that at all. You know, unless you're playing with the band for a long time, you know the songs inside out. But you never know what's happening on stage. You know, you'd be doing that, and somebody passed out, you know. Oh, okay. So just scan. Keep your eyes and ears open. Okay, next question.
What's for dinner?
They said that?
Yeah, everyone wants to know what's for dinner.
You know, Sunday we went to the winery. We live near the wineries here. And afterward, we went to Mexican food with my brother, my sister, my nieces, and my
great-nephew.
Yeah. And we went for Mexican food already, so we're not going to go for Mexican food. We're going, Lala's making.
Oh, veggie patties, just kind of a simple dinner. Macaroni and cheese, potatoes, peas. Vinny wants peas.
Well, because it's not so carbohydrate-y, you know. Peas! Okay, let's take one more question.
One more question. What was your favorite moment from Rock and Roll Fantasy Camp?
Which one?
I don't know. It doesn't say.
Favorite moment? You know what? We played the Playboy Mansion a long time ago. That was pretty cool. You know, that was a big camp. There must have been 150, maybe more people invited to that. It's the Thursday night party, and we played. And it was outside the Playboy Mansion. The thing with the Playboy Mansion, everybody thinks, oh, man, I'm gonna bring a bathrobe and sit down with Hugh Hefner. He was alive at the time. And, you know, see the chicks walk by. And it's not, or go inside and have a drink with Hugh. No, they don't really let you inside. The outside by the pool's beautiful. And there's jacuzzis. There's all that stuff. So you don't need to go inside. But that was pretty cool. The only problem with it is Beverly Hills, and people were complaining noise too loud. And they gave us those sticks. I don't know what you call them, like bamboo, look like a bunch of chopsticks together, so it's not as loud. And so a couple people played, and I got up to play. I said, I'm not using those. That's ridiculous. So I just used sticks, but I played lower. Yeah, I wasn't trying to cause trouble. So that was a really cool thing, cool highlight. And, you know, there's always something happening at the rock camps. They're really cool. So David Fischoff's the one that puts all this stuff together. So, okay then. Well, we good? Hey, it's time to eat. Anyway, thank you guys for coming. And Jay, Sharon, all you guys, Steve, watching me. And I don't know if Heidi's on or Angelo and... Paul,
Bill,
yeah.
Robert, a lot of people.
Yeah. You remember Romper Room?
Yes.
She used to hold up this thing as a circle, and she used to look at the camera like she could see you and sitting there watching the show. I see Vinny. I see Carmine. And they're making a lot of noise. I see Lollipop. Paul, Heidi. And you'd sit there young going, wow, how did she do that? She could see me through the TV. So anyway, thank you guys. I'll be here next week, I think. Yeah, I'm here next week, so tune in and have some fun. Okay, be safe. Bye.